أنشط الجنان والفوز والغنيمة، فخذ هذه المعاني بسيطة عظيمة. الدين بالأخلاق بالجود والعزيمة، بالحب والوفاق حياتنا كريمة.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. رب زدني علما، اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. I welcome you all to the class of Sahih al-Bukhari. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we are beginning with the Book of Faith. Right? We are beginning with the Book of Faith, Kitabul Iman. Kitabul Iman, the Book of Faith. And inshallah ta'ala, we are going to read from here. Yesterday, we did the previous ones, right? The previous seven hadiths. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we will continue from the remaining ones, the Kitabul Iman, the Book of Belief. So he says, faith, that is to believe in the six articles of faith. That's, and he continued with this because about the faith, because Aqidah is so important that all the amal of a person depends on it, right? All amal of a person depends on it, and it really matters that what he believes in. So, to believe in the six articles of faith: Allah, His Allah's angels, His Allah's messengers, His Allah's books, the Torah, the Gospel, the Quran, etc. Right, so, it is the six articles of faith, that is believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in angels, believing in the messengers, believing in His books, the Torah, Injil, and the Quran, the Gospel, the Day of Resurrection, Al-Qadr. Right, faith has more than 60 subdivisions or parts. The highest one is La ilaha illallah, and the lowest one is to remove harmful things from the ways, roadway, roads, passages, etc. And that is the lowest belief of a person. So he starts with the first babu qawlin nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, bunya al-islam mu ala khamsin. Right, so he starts the Kitabul Iman, the Book of Iman. And we have almost 50 ahadiths here in Kitabul Iman. And this is what is based upon Kitabul Iman. So he says, Babu Qawlin Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Bunya al-Islam wa ala khams. And he brings the hadith that Islam is based on five principles. And we know this hadith is very famous. Wa huwa qawlun wa fi'lun wa yazidu wa yanqus. Right? And belief is both a qawl, right? Statement, and wa fi'lun, actions. وَيَزِيدُ وَيَنْقُسْ, and it increases and it decreases. Right? وَيَزِيدُ وَيَنْقُسُ, it increases and it decreases. This is refuting all the other people who say that it is only, like the Murji'ah, they say that it is only statement. Right? It is only statement, while some people say that no, it is both. It is just actions, and some people say it is just belief. So he says, it is qawlun. Iman is qawlun. Qawlun wa fi'lun wa yazidu wa yanqus. And it increases and decreases. Qala Allah Ta'ala, liyazdadu imanam ma'a imanihim. Right? Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala revealed the following verses concerning subject, that they grow, liyazdadu imanam ma'a imanihim. That they grow more in faith along with their present faith. And so Iman increases as well as decreases. Right? Iman increases as well as decreases. And this was the dalil given. Al-Fat. Wazidnahum huda. That they may grow more in faith along with their present faith. Right? And we increase them in guidance. Surah Al-Kahf. وَيَزِيدُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا هُدَى. And Allah increases in guidance those who walk aright, who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's bringing evidences for that the Iman increases. وَقَالَ وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًا وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ. Right? وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا. And Allah increases those who walk right. And this word. And he said, as for those who accept, who fear Allah much, and love Allah much. right? And Allah increases in guidance. وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ those who walk aright, right? هُدَى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ and we increase them in guidance. And this was Surah Mudassir. Oh, he didn't translate how. And the believers may increase in faith. So وَإِزْدَادُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِيمَانًا and Surah Muhammad also. As for those who accept guidance, he increases their guidance, bestows on them their piety. وَإِزْدَادُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِيمَانًا وَقَوْلُهُ أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ هَذِي إِيمَانًا فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا and the believers may increase. Which of you had his faith increased by it? As for those who believe, it has increased. So he's bringing evidence because many people said that there is no iman does not increase and it decreases also. So he's bringing a lot of evidences to prove. فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَوْلُهُ وَقَوْلُهُ جَلَّ ذِكْرُهُ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا right? And this is the verse of Al-Iman. Fear them, but it only increased them in faith. وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَلَى وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا and also Allah's statement, جَلَّ جَلَالَهُ it only added to their faith and to their submissiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So, this is what he has brought various evidences that this is what the evidence is that iman increases as well as it decreases, right? وَالْحُبُّ فِي اللَّهِ وَالْبُغْضُ فِي اللَّهِ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ and to love and hate for Allah's sake is a part of faith, right? To love and hate for the part of for Allah's sake is part of faith. وَكَتَبَ عُمَرْ ابْنِ عَبْدِ الْعَزِيزِ so he's giving a you know an introduction about these ahadith. وَكَتَبَ عُمَرْ ابْنُ عَبْدِ الْعَزِيزِ إِلَىٰ عَدِي ابْنَ عَدِي right? Umar ibn al-Aziz wrote to Adi ibn Adi. So Umar ibn al-Aziz wrote a letter, إِنَّ لِلْإِيمَانَ فَرَائِدَ وَشَرَاعِيَ belief includes faraid, right? And legal laws, وَشَرَاعِيَ وَحُدُودًا وَسُنَنَا and boundary limits of lawful and unlawful things. فَمَنْ اسْتَكْمَلَهَا اسْتَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانَ and whoever follows all of them completely has completed his has a complete belief. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَكْمِلْهَا لَمْ يَسْتَكْمِلِ الْإِيمَانِ So he says that there are a lot of conditions for iman and stuff, right? And whoever completes them, he has completed iman. And whoever does not complete all these conditions, then لَمْ يَسْتَكْمِلِ الْإِيمَانِ فَإِنْ عَيْشْ فَسَأُبَيِّنُهَا لَكُمْ حَتَّى تَعَمَلُوا بِهَا And should I live, I'll tell you all about them, right? So that you may act on them. وَإِنْ أَمُتْ فَمَا أَنَا عَلَىٰ صُحْبَتِكُمْ بِحَرِيصٍ And should I die, I'm not anxious to have your company. Right? So he was a lot troubled by the various stuff, right? He was troubled by people, you know, they were very corrupted at that his time. And his khilafah was only like 2.5 years, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. So he just lived for, I mean, for 2.5 years with his khilafah. And he was very pious, right? So many people call him the sixth khalifa or sometimes the fifth khalifa, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, rahimahullah. He's a tabi'i. And he was very tired about the people and he said that, وَإِنْ أَمُتْ And if I die, فَمَا أَنَا عَلَىٰ صُحْبَتِكُمْ بِحَدِيثٍ I'm not anxious to have your company. Right? وَقَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي And Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam said, but to be stronger in faith. Because yaqeen, like if just one person said it, you might believe it once. But if like 2, 3, 4 hundreds of people say it, you might have more yaqeen. Right? And if you see it with your own eyes, the level of yaqeen, the level of certainty in your faith will be something else. So that is why Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, please show me, right? كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَ How you give life to death. And he was asked to bring all the birds together and so on. Okay, so وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي But to be stronger in faith. And وَقَالَ مُعَاذ And Mu'adh said, اِدْلِسْ بِنَا نُؤْمِنْ سَعَةً Let us sit for a while so that we may dedicate the period of time to faith. Right, so he said that we should let's believe for some time. Let's renew our faith. Because iman is something which needs to be renewed all the time again. Right? Iman. وَقَالَ ابْنُ مَسْعُودَ الْيَقِينُ الْإِيمَانُ كُلُّهُ Yaqeen is perfect faith. Yes, having certainty. about the day of judgment, about life and so on. وقال ابن عمر لا يبلغ العبد حقيقة التقوى حتى يدع ما حاك في صدره. And a person cannot attain true sense of piety unless and until he removes all suspicions from his heart. And removing all suspicions about the day of judgment and so on. وقال مجاهد شرع لكم. That is, أوسيناك يا محمد وياه دينا واحدا. وقال ابن عباس شرعة ومنهاجا سبيلا وسنة. And so the Mujahid said he has ordained for you, means O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he has given you a sharia to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we have ordained for you and one religion. Ibn Abbas and Allah and a clear way. It's Islamic way and sunnah. So he started the Kitabul Iman by giving all these, you know, Babu Qawli Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Buniya al-Islamu ala khams. That the Islam is based on five principles, and he brought verses about the Iman increasing and decreasing. And we should believe that the Iman increases and decreases. And if a person sins, then his iman decreases, and if he does good deeds, then his iman increases. Right, so a person, it's not an iman is qawlun wa amalun. It's also it's saying it also, and there's action also is a part of iman. Because many people say just if you say la ilaha illallah, it's enough. No need to do actions. Like the Christians say, like if you just believe in Jesus, then it's fine. But that's not true, right? That's not true because just saying la ilaha illallah is not enough. Right, one has to show it with his actions also. That is also part of iman. قَوْلٌ اَعْتَقَادٌ فِي الْقَلْبِ It is in the heart. And then قَوْلٌ It is a statement as well as with the جَوَارِح, with the body parts. Then he brings a second bab. بَابٌ دُعَى So he'll bring all ahadith, relating to iman. Right, iman, faith. So he brings the second bab. دُعَاءُكُمْ إِيمَانُكُمْ Your invocation means your faith. Right, الدُّعَاء هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ Right, iman is dua, because when we invocate Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, when we call upon Allah Subhanahu, that is out of faith, right? So Allah says, لِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ Right, say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the disbelievers, my Lord pays attention to you only because of your invocation to Him. Right, قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ يَعْبَأُ is to pay attention. Right, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only pays attention to the disbelievers only because of their dua. So even they do dua, right? Even they do dua indirectly or directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah accepts them many times. الدُّعَى فِي اللُّغَةِ al-iman. So he says that the dua is also based on faith in language. Then now he brings the hadith of faith. حَدَّثَنَا عُبَيْدُ اللَّهِ ibn Musa قَالْ أخبرنا حنظلة ابن أبي سفيان عن عكرمة ابن خالد. From Ubaidullah ibn Musa, so Imam Bukhari heard from Ubaidullah ibn Musa, قال, then he said that أخبرنا حنظلة, that حنظلة ابن أبي سفيان informed us عن عكرمة ابن خالد, that is number three, right? عكرمة ابن خالد عن ابن عمر. So ابن عمر, the Sahabi, there are three people here, right? عكرمة, then حنظلة, and Ubaidullah ibn Musa. And Ubaidullah ibn Musa. These are the three people which are there. So, عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم This is the hadith very famous from ابن عمر رضي الله عنه. Narrated ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said Islam is based on the following five principles, right? شهادتي أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله. Right? To testify لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله. None has the right to be worshipped but Allah. And that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? The second is wa iqam as-salah, to perform the compulsory congregational salah, iqam as-salah, wa ita az-zakah, to pay zakah, wal hajj, and to perform hajj, wa sawmi ramadan, and to observe fast. Right? In some hadith, hajj comes late and ramadan comes before. But this is the, in hadith number 8, the numbers here. Right? The number counting is like this. Right, أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله إقام الصلاة إيتاء الزكاة الحج والصوم رمضان and to observe Ramadan. So this is about the second bab, right? Babu دعاءكم إيمانكم. Then babu أمور الإيمان. Right? What are babs? Babs are like chapters, right? Each book has several chapters. Right? So this is all about iman, but in that he'll bring babs, right? Chapter, small chapters, yeah, small chapters. So, umur al-iman regarding the deeds of faith. Right? وقولي, so he brings words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وقول الله عز وجل ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق. And the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not al-birr, every act of obedience to Allah, that you turn your faces to east or west in prayers. ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر. And birr, the righteousness is the one who believes in Allah, the last day. والملائكة والكتاب. أي والكتاب والنبيين وآت المال على حبه وذوي القربى واليتامى. To believe in the books and the prophets and give his wealth in spite of the love for it to the kings for it and to the orphans and to al masakin. وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب. And to the wayfarer and to those who ask. وأقام الصلاة. And to perform الصلاة. وآت الزكاة. وَالْمُوفُونَ بِعَدِهِمْ إِذَا أَعَهَدُوا. And gives the zakat and who fulfill the covenant when they make it. And who are patient. So this is all a list of all the, you know, the birr. What is righteousness? وَالصَّابِرِينَ فِي الْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَحِينَ الْبَأْسِ. And those who are patient in ailment at the time of fighting. Right? أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. These are the people who are truth, the people of truth, and they are the muttaqun. Right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so this is all right, believing in Allah, last day, angels, messengers, prophets, giving his wealth in spite of the love for it, to the kings for it, to the orphans, to masakin, wayfarer, right? To set the slave free, then perform a salah and give his zakah, and to fulfill the covenant and the ailment at the time of fighting. Such are the people of truth, and they are the muttaqun. And the other verse he brings, qad aflaha al-mu'minun. Right? Indeed, successful indeed are the believers. And successfully indeed are the believers. So he brings all these verses about it. Ninth hadith. So this was the hadith. I mean, eighth hadith was about the five pillars of Islam. Then the ninth hadith, Haddasna Abdullah ibn Muhammad. So Imam Bukhari hears from the first person, Abdullah ibn Muhammad. Haddasna Abu Amir al-Aqdi. So he hears from Abu Amir al-Aqdi. Haddas Sulaiman ibn Bilal, third person. An Abdullah ibn Dinar. Right, fourth person here, An Abi Saleh. So five people here. The five people here from the Sahabi. So six, right? An Abi Hurayra an Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The actual Rabi is Abu Hurayra radiallahu anhu, an Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Al Imanu bid'un wa sittuna shu'ba. Right, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Al Imanu bid'un. Faith consists of more than 60 subdivisions. Wa sittuna shu'ba. I thought the faith has more than 60 subdivisions or branches. Right? والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. الحياء. الحياء means, you know, modesty, shyness. الحياء covers a large number of concepts which are to be taken together. Amongst them are self-respect, modesty, bashfulness, and honor is a part of faith. شعبة. شعبة is a part of faith. Right? صفات الباري, he says. So these are the parts. So he has given 60 subdivisions, and he said حياء. Is also. So Iman has levels, like one level or the level, second level, third level, fourth level, fifth level, and so on. And the least of it, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that removing things from the path, removing things from the path, and that is also a part of Iman. And his haya is also a part of Iman. Then he brings another bab, the fourth bab, Babun al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisani wa yadi. And he brings the hadith, the bab's heading itself is, a Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslim with his tongue and his hands. Haddasna Adam ibn Abi Iyas, first person, Haddasna Shu'aba, and Abdullah, third person, ibn Abi Safar or Ismail, and Sha'abi. Sha'abi was a tabi'i, and he heard from Abdullah ibn Umar. So four people here. So sometimes four, sometimes five, sometimes he has three people between him and the sahabi. And Abdullah ibn Amrin, so this Amrin, this waw is just for the sake of Amr, right? Abdullah ibn Amr, an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al Muslimu man salima al Muslimuna. Right? A Muslim is the one who avoids harming the Muslims, other Muslims, man salima. Salima is to be safe. One who's safe, man salima al Muslimuna, min lisanihi wa yadihi. Right? With his tongue and hands, who avoids harming other Muslims with his tongue and his hands. So he does not backbite, he does not curse other Muslims, and he does not do bad things with his hands. And a muhajir is the one who gives up all what Allah has forbidden. and wal muhajiru man hajara ma naha Allah anhu. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the muhajir, the emigrant who gives whatever Allah has forbidden, right? And he says that waqala Abdullah waqala Abu Muawiyah, and he brings another narration link for it. حدثنا داود عن عامر قال سمعت عبد الله بن عامر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال عبد الله على عن داود عن عامر عن عبد الله عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he brings two narrations, two sanads for here. So this hadith is all about, you know, that we should not harm other Muslims with our tongue and our hands. And we can remember this also very simple hadith. المسلم من سلم المسلمون باللسان من لسانه ويديه من لسانه ويديه والمهاجر من هجر منها الله عنه. Right, al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi. Qala alayhi salatu wa salam. Babun ayyul islami afdal. Then he brings the next chapter. So every hadith is putting like a title, right? Title. And sometimes in each bab he'll bring so many hadiths, and sometimes in each bab there's only one hadith like we have here. So he says, Babun ayyul islami afdal. Whose Islam is the best? And whose Islam is the best? So he brings hadithan Sa'id ibn Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qurashi. So this is narration Sa'id ibn Yahya. Qala haddathna Abi, the second person. Haddathna Abu Burda, third person. Ibn Abdullah bin Abi Burda. An Abi Burda. Right? From his father, Abi Burda. Fourth person, an Abi Musa. Radiallahu. Abu Musa was a Sahabi. Radiallahu anhu. Qalu, Ya Rasulullah, Ayyul Islami Afdal. Some people ask Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose Islam is the best? Right? That is, who is a very good Muslim. Qala, من سلم المسلمون من لساني ويديه. So this is the same hadith, but here the context is different, that whose Islam is the best. So he says, one who avoids harming the Muslims with his tongue and hands. Right? So the one who avoids harming the Muslims with his tongue and his hands is the one who is best. Right? So his Islam is the best. So this is about Abu Musa radiallahu anhu. He brings the hadith. Then Babun, إطعام الطعام من الإسلام. To feed others is a part of Islam. To feed others, other people and so on. حدثنا عمر بن خالد قال حدثنا الليث عن يزيد بن أبي الخير عن عبد الله بن عمر عمر رضي الله عنه. So this is hadith from عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنه. أن رجلا سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the man asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أي الإسلام خير. So here it was, Ayyul Islami Afdal, which Islam is the best? And here also, Ayyul Islami Khair, whose Islam is good? Or what sort of good deeds Islam are good? Faqala, so he said something different here, and he said, Tut'imu Ta'am. At'ama yut'imu is to feed someone. So he says, Tut'imu Ta'am, right? To feed people. Wa taqra'u salama, and to say salam. And greet ala man arafta wa man lam ta'arif. Arafa ya'arifu is to know. So to those whom you know and those whom you do not know. Right? Ala man arafta wa ala man wa man lam ta'arif. So he brought two things. Good Islam is the one who tut'imu ta'am wa taqra'u salam ala man arafta wa man lam ta'arif. That you say salam to the one who know and those who do not know. Then the next chapter, Babun min al-Imani an yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsihi. Right? So it is from the Iman to like for one's brother what one likes for himself is a part of faith. And haddathna Musaddad qal, haddathna Yahya an Shu'bah an Qatada an Anas radiallahu anhu an al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this hadith is from Anas radiallahu anhu. An Husayn al-Muallim qal, حدثنا قتادة عن أنس عن النبي. So he brings another link. قال لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. Right? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, none of you will have faith till he likes for his brother what he likes for himself. Right? It is necessary for a Muslim to like for his brother what he likes for himself. Right? A person should not be selfish and so on. He should be generous, and he should like for others what he likes for himself. Like if he does not want harm for himself, he should not harm the others also. So this is also a beautiful hadith about it. Yeah, famous hadith. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. Yeah, it's a famous. Kids are made to learn it. Yes, right. kids are made to learn this hadith. And then if you will have faith, till he likes for his Muslim brother what he likes for himself. Babun hubbur rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam min al iman. To love the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam is also a part of faith. So it's bringing, you know, a hadith again and again about iman, and one hadith, right? To feed others is also part of Islam and iman, right? Whose Islam is the best? The best is the one who man salim al muslimun min lisanihi wa yadihi. And this is what to love the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is a part of faith. That's small hadith, very beautiful hadith about faith, right? Haddathna Abu al-Yaman qala akhbarna Shu'aib qala haddathna Abu Zinad an al-Araj an Abi Hurairah. So this is hadith from Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu an an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam qala walladhi nafsi biyadihi, right? By him in whose hands my life is. This is like an oath, right? La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walidihi wa waladihi. Right? None of you will have faith till he loves me more than his father and his children. And to loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a part of faith, right? And he should love after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the most, it should be the most. And what does it mean to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is to follow his commandments, to follow his sunnah, to listen to whatever he has prohibited from, he should stop from it. Right, to follow his ways of everything, how he lived his life, and that is love for Allah, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. It is not like the people say, just, you know, lip service, and they just make a show of love of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, but they do not follow it. They do not even read his ahadith. They do not read his seerah. They don't know anything about him alayhi salatu wasalam, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lived his life for the ummah, but people do not care and they live the life selfishly without even reading about the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. So the Prophet himself said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِ لَا يُؤْمِنُ. Nobody believes, yeah? Nobody has faith. That is complete faith. أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ. أَحَبَّ is to be more beloved. إِلَيْهِ مِنْ وَالِدِهِ وَوَالَدِهِ. Walid is father and walid is son, right? And his children. And another hadith of the same from Anas an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam haddasa Adam qal haddasa Shu'ba an Qatada an Anas qal qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam la yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna. Akuna is when I, until I become. La yu'minu ahadukum, none of you believe, will have faith, hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walidihi wa waladihi. Will have faith till he loves me more than his father and his children. وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ, and all mankind. So this hadith, why did you bring this hadith? Because وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ, right? And all mankind also. All mankind, and his father and his children and his wife. And he should love the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam more than anything else. Right? After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then بَابٌ حَلَاوَةُ الْإِيمَانِ, right? Sweetness of faith. Sweetness of faith. حدثنا محمد بن المثنى قال حدثنا عبد الوهاب الثقفي قال حدثنا أيوب عن أبي قلابة عن أنس رضي الله عنه. So this hadith is from Anas رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. So this is about sweetness of faith. That three people will have the sweetness of faith. ثلاث من كن فيه وجد حلاوة الإيمان. حلاوة is sweetness, right? So he will find sweetness of faith. First one. أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. The one to whom Allah Ta'ala and His Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam become dearer than anything else. And the whole world, the whole his family or whatever it is, these Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and His Messenger become dearer to him. Right? He wants to study about them. He wants to follow the Islam and follow the footsteps of the Prophet Alayhi Salatu Wasalam and the Sahaba. So everything, you know, they too become dear to him. So he will taste the sweetness of the faith. And this person will taste the sweetness of this of the faith. And أن يكون الله, the second thing is أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواه. Right? Second thing, أن يحب المرء لا يحبه إلا الله. Who loves a person and he loves him only for Allah's sake. Right? A righteous brother, a righteous sister, whatever, yeah. You love only that person only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to meet and to greet him only for his sake, without any personal benefits, without anything, right? Only for his sake. You and يحب المرأة لا يحبه إلا لله. Who loves a person and he loves him only for, so the both of them, right? Both of them only love for the sake of Allah, only for the sake of Allah, and they meet only for Allah's sake, and they hate each other. I mean, if there's a problem, only for Allah's sake, right? They don't have any other need, not monetary, not they're not family, they're not you know, just they just have the concern for each other only for Allah's sake. So these two people will also will taste the sweetness of faith, because they're meeting together. So they'll talk only with about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the religion, about the deen, and about learning knowledge and so on, right? And they will only speak to each other about these things. So they will feel the sweetness of faith. And the third thing is, وَأَنْ يَقْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ كَمَا يَقْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. Who hates to revert to atheism or disbelief, right? Kufr, they translate it as atheism, but kufr. كَمَا يَقْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ is to throw. يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ, as he hates to be thrown into the fire. Right? He hates to go back to his previous religion, or to go back to kufr, right? As he hates to be thrown into the fire. Because he has, so whoever hates so much, he will taste the sweetness of the faith. It's like reverse, right? I mean, he doesn't go back. He doesn't, I mean, even if he's thrown into the fire, he will not revert from, go back to kufr, right? Go back from Islam. So these three people, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that he will taste the sweetness of it, halawatul iman. And these three people are the ones, right? Very, so the first one, who loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and his messenger. The second one, who loves a person more only for Allah's sake. And the third, who hates to revert to disbelief, to kufr. Then he brings another hadith, alamatul iman hubbul ansar. To love the ansar is a sign of faith. Right? Ansar are the sahabi who lived in Medina, right? The sahaba who lived in Medina are called ansar. And to love them is a part of faith. Okay, because the Prophet said so. Because muhajir are the ones who went from Makkah to Medina. And the ansar are the ones who stayed in Medina and they helped. Ansar, nasar wa yansuru is to help, right? So ansar are the one, nasir, the plural is ansar, the one who helped the muhajirs. They gave them their homes, they gave them the wives, and divorced one wife, they gave the property, half of everything was given, half of, and they supported the muhajirs so much. Radiallahu anhum ajma'in. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave in hadith, sami'atu anasan, radiallahu anhu nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qal, ayatul imani hubbul ansar. To love the ansar is a sign of faith. Wa ayatul nifaqi bughdul ansar. And to hate the ansar is a sign of hypocrisy. And to hate the ansar is a sign of hypocrisy. Then we have another hadith about Bab. He didn't give a heading here. So this is how, right? This is how the hadith books are. Like, you have a topic. In that topic, there could be so many hadiths about so many topics. Right? Now we have about Hansar, and previously we had about Halawatul Iman. And this is how. So it's sometimes it's very good to read the books of our hadiths, because it's not monotonous. Like one topic, and then you have long paragraphs or long essays or, and long topic about it. No, it is quick shifting, right? Quick shift. One hadith, the next hadith, one next hadith. So we learn a lot. We learn Aqidah, we learn Seerah, we learn stories, right? We learn so many things, right? So this is how it is. Fiqh also, yeah? Fiqh. Haddasna Abu al-Yaman. This is the hadith. And this is the hadith number 18. Right? And inshallah, we'll end it with this hadith. Yeah, inshallah, we'll end it with this hadith. Inshallah ta'ala. So this was the hadith of Bayatul Aqaba, which took place, right? The people came from Medina and they made a pact of allegiance to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-Aqaba. So, Akhbarna Shu'ayb an Zuhri, Imam Zuhri, qala Akhbarna Abu Idris Aizun, Aizullah ibn Abdullah and Ubad ibn Samit. So this hadith is from Ubad ibn Samit radiallahu anhu, kana shahida Badran, and he took part in the Battle of Badr. So Ubada, he was a Badri sahabi. Right? He took part in the Battle of Badr. وَهُوَ أَحَدٌ نُقَبَى, and he was one of the Naqib. So Naqib are the people who, six people who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet was giving da'wah in the year 10th, 11th, 11, 12, 13 to the tribes, right? They used to come to Makkah and he used to give them da'wah. And six people accepted Islam, right? And they were called the Naqib, Nuqaba, then one of the Naqib, and six people. And then next year they brought 12 people, right? So Nuqaba, Laylatul Aqaba, on the night of Aqaba pledge. So the Prophet says, Anna Rasulullah, so he gave them an allegiance, like, this is this you should do, this is this you should not do. Anna Rasulullah SAW qala wa hawlahu Isabatu ibn Sahaba. Isaba is a group. And there was a group of companions, min ashabihi. So he said, give me bay'a. So you have to put the hand on the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and said, bay'uni. The first thing, Allah tushriku billahi shay'an. That you won't do shirk. Not to join anything in worship along with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَسْرِقُوا you will not steal. وَلَا تَزْنُوا you will not commit illegal sexual intercourse. No zina. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ you will not kill your children. And no killing girls, right? It's all gone now. وَلَا تَأْتُوا بِبُهْتَانٍ تَفْتَرُونَهُ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَالْجُلِكُمْ not to utter slander, intentionally forging falsehood. And by making illegal children belonging to the husbands. So you cannot, give buhtan to the women. Or not to accuse an innocent person and to spread such an accusation among people. So Bhutan is accusing some false here. It was very common, right? Wala, then say, wala ta'asu fi ma'ruf, and not be disobedient in ma'ruf. In ma'ruf is good deeds. Right? So not be, asa yasi is to disobey. Faman wafa minkum fa'ajruhu ala Allah. At whoever, then the Prophet added, whoever amongst you fulfills his pledge, he will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَصَابَ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ شَيْئًا فَعُوقِبَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَهُوَ كَفَّارَةٌ لَهُ وَمَنْ أَصَابَ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ شَيْئًا ثُمَّ سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنْ شَاءَ عَفَانُهُ وَإِنْ شَاءَ عَاقَبَهُ فَبَايَعْنَاهُ عَلَى ذَٰلِكَ And we gave back to him on that. Whoever amongst you fulfills his pledge will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever indulges in any of these sins, so whatever sins he mentioned, gets the punishment in this world, right? Gets the punishment. That punishment will be an expiation for him from that sin. And if one indulges in any of them, that is in any of these sins, and Allah conceals his sin. So either whoever indulges, he'll get the punishment and that'll be an expiation for him. Punishment. If he's not punished in this world and Allah conceals it, and Allah hides it, it is up to him. So he can forgive them or punish him in the hereafter. Because Allah accepts shirk, everything he forgives, right? He can forgive. He can forgive if he wants. Ubadah ibn Samit then added, so we give the bay'ah for these, right? He gave the bay'ah for these ahadith, for these things, right? So bay'ahna for these things. Okay, so we'll continue from Babun min ad-dini al-firadu min al-fitan. To run away from afflictions and trials is a part of religion, is a part of deen. Right? To run away when there's a lot of problem in the society and it's not a correct society to live in, Islamic society. And it's, I mean, we are not able to practice our religion. So it is from the religion to do hijrah, that place to another place where he can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala freely. We'll read this ahadith next week, inshallah ta'ala. So today we did almost 10 ahadiths. Right, let's go through them once again about shortly. From hadith number 8. Right? Hadith number 8. Right? Hadith number 8. We believe this was hadith about the five pillars of Islam. Right? Then the hadith number 9. This was about that faith is consists of 60 parts. 60 and haya min al iman. Modesty is also part of faith. Then hadith number 10. We should not harm others with our tongue and hands. Al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisani wa yadih. And this hadith is, whose Islam is the best? The same hadith number 11, min lisani wa yadih. And the hadith number 12 is to feed others is also part of Iman. Tut'imul ta'am. And to say the salam is also part of Iman. And hadith number 13, that we should love for our brothers what we love for ourselves. Right? لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. This was the hadith, and then we had the next hadith. والذي to love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, hadith number 14, and to love him more than the mankind, hadith 15, and sweetness of faith. We learned about this hadith of sweetness of faith. Three people: one, who loves Allah and His Messenger dearly more than anything else in the world. Second, who loves a brother for the sake of Allah's sake, right? And third, who hates to revert to kufr, right? These three people will taste, inshallah, the sweetness of faith. And the sweetness of faith. And then we have Hubbul Ansari min al Iman. To love the Ansar is also a sign of faith. And the last hadith about the Bay'atul Aqaba, right? The Aqaba pledge, which Ubadah ibn Samit, who was one of the Naqib Ubadah, he said that there was the Bay'ah that we should not do six things, right? Six things which we should not do. You should not do shirk, not seal, no zina, no killing a children, and no buhtan, and not to be disobedient. And this was the bay'ah which we read. So these were the hadith from hadith number 8 till hadith number 18. They're like, this Babul Iman consists till 58. Hadith till hadith 58. Inshallah. So we can do 10 hadith. So we did 10 hadith today. Maybe next time we can do more. 15 maybe. It depends on how the hadiths are built up. Right, and after Babul Iman, we have totally 94 Bab, right? 94 kitabs, 97 books. Right, after this belief, we have Kitabul Ilm and knowledge, and from in that we have Hadith 59 to 134. Right? About knowledge, he'll bring Hadith to learn the religion and so on. He'll bring various Hadith about that. Then we will bring in the actual fiqh about wudu from Hadith 135 to 247, like the various things in wudu, everything, yeah, everything about wudu and all the hadiths which are repeated about wudu, and then ghusl, then we have hayat, menstrual periods, and then we have tayammum, and so on, inshallah ta'ala. This is what we will try to read every day, I mean every week, 10 hadiths or 15 hadiths, and inshallah we'll get to know various hadiths about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, which he said and which he did. This is what is reading Sahih Bukhari. Once we finish Sahih Bukhari, maybe 1 or 2 or 3 years, we can start with Sahih Al-Muslim, inshallah ta'ala. And there are 9 volumes of this book, inshallah ta'ala. So see you in the next class, next Wednesday. Jazakallahu khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our work and our reading of the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الرحمن الرحيم